Hello, insiders. Today we're going to talk about a new feature in YouTube Analytics to help you better understand your video retention on a totally new level. And today I'm going to speak to Dan, who's working on this feature. Dan, do you want to introduce yourself?
Absolutely. Hey, Alina. So my name's Dan. I'm an interaction designer on Studio, and specifically, I work on analytics.
Cool. So tell us a bit more. Why did you decide to launch a new audience retention card? And what is the difference with the old one?
There is an audience retention graph today, but for one thing, that only exists at the video level. So there's not really a great way, other than going into individual videos, to compare audience retention across them. Additionally, it's not very visual and it can be difficult to interpret what that means for creators. So we wanted to pick out some of what's happening in that graph and that line that it's describing and surface those moments, key moments is what we're calling them, for different videos. So we're doing this at the channel level as well as at the individual video level.
Okay, so what are those moments?
Yeah, so we've picked out four key moments, and naming these was really hard. We went back and forth a lot on the names for these, but what we ended up with is the intro, so the first 30 seconds of the video. And we know that's really important because that's your chance to hook viewers. We're ranking that by the number of people still watching after 30 seconds. Secondly, we have continuous segments, which is when there's a period when the graph is basically flat, and that means really no one is leaving the video. So that indicates you have really engaging content there. And then spikes and dips are the last two. So a spike could mean a couple of different things. It could mean either people are rewatching that section or there's a timestamp there and viewers are getting linked to that point. And then also a dip could mean a number of different things, typically that people are leaving the video at that point or they're skipping over it.
This sounds really interesting. And do you have any tips about how creators can use this data?
Sure, definitely. So we almost called this card highlights. We went away from that because that implies good things are happening, and these aren't necessarily always good. So for an example, if there's a spike, people are rewatching a section, that could mean that it's a more engaging moment, or people think it's funny, or they want to see it again. But it could also mean that the audio cuts out, or there's something happening in the background that people are distracted by. So, what we're hoping is that by surfacing these key moments, and especially at the channel level, creators can look across their videos and see what notable things are happening and find patterns in those. So for continuous segments, those, the longer they are, the better they are. So we've ranked them from longest to shortest. And if you have a really long continuous segment of viewers watching, that typically means that's really engaging content. And so I would recommend watching that segment and kind of thinking about what's happening there, what can you do with that information to make more of that content in the future. So really, the overarching question that we were looking to answer with this feature is, what video should I make next? So hopefully with this information, creators can say, okay, now I kind of have a sense for what's resonating with my audience, what they find really engaging, and I can do more of that in the future.
All right, so I have very last question. Can everyone see this card?
Everyone should be able to see the card. The videos that show up are your most recent. And if certain videos don't meet the criteria, for example, they have to be at least a minute long, I think, and a few other criteria, they won't show up in the list necessarily.
Do you have any questions for Creator Insider audience then?
Yes, kind of an invitation to weigh in on where this goes next. So we're really excited about this. We think it has a lot of potential for creators, but also we know that we can do a lot more with this and take it in a lot of different directions. So we'd love to hear from folks what they want to see next, and we are excited to hear from them and incorporate that feedback into deciding what to do next with this.
Thanks for coming to the show, Dan.
Thank you.
So try the new feature, leave your feedback, and keep it real.